Malkin finessed his way into the offensive zone. Cradles it. Gonchar slap pass. Crosby rink wide. Whitney closing in to the front. Score! Ryan Whitney gets a favorable bounce and Pittsburgh takes the lead.
Ron Stevens a little bit beside himself. Biron has seen that happen before. First goal in game one, power play from the other side, mind you, but a fortuitous bounce off the defenseman. This time it's Jason Smith. In game one, it was Lassie Hukkanen, Coke Zero. Goal cam shows you that Martin Biron was going post to post, and the Penguins are going up in the air because they lead 1-0.
The Penguin captain is Sidney Crosby, not beloved in Philadelphia one iota. Hossa, score! Magical moves by Marion Hossa.
Certainly not the start John Stevens and his gang were looking for. Marion Hossa silencing, stunning the Philly faithful. Handling the puck, and everybody think he's gonna dish it to Sidney Crosby. He doesn't. He takes it and snaps it back against the grain. Isolation, what? I've got room. Hossa says, I've got room. Little crossover move. Everybody kind of cheating, leaning left where Sidney Crosby is opening up ice down the wing. And shovel it out the other side.
Scotty Upshaw mauled there by Gill. From LA in February. Crosspull, another trade acquisition, tries to wrap, rebound, score! R.J. Umberger!
Looking for a reason to cheer and a reason to find some kind of rhythm, but there hasn't been much for either side. Just call RJ as an Umberger, as they've done throughout the postseason. Umberger has been the guy to deliver. Nobody tracks him, and he just pokes it atop of the paint.
And trying to wear him out. As Hartnell got there ahead of Fleury, who couldn't touch it. It's loose, and it dribbles wide. Rebound chance. At the doorstep, Fleury goes to the splits and ties up the puck long enough for the whistle.
Hey. Why not? Why not have a goalie go behind the net and do something rather spastic? That's what this period's been all about.
Great word. But he couldn't play it.
I know.
And Hartnell baited him to try and do it.
And then, here it is. Little cat and mouse. Oh, great heads up play by Hartnell to bank it in off him. Now he can't get up. And give him full marks for, look at Fleury, I've got gloves behind him, I leave my stick, oh my goodness, where's the puck? Now it hits him, he's reaching for his hockey stick.
Holmgren, the general manager.
Richards makes another strip. Richards is in on the backhand. Great diving poke check by Gonchar.
Great effort by everybody involved. Coke Zero goal cam won't tell you about the potential for a penalty. Just what it's like to be a goaltender. I think that is a tremendous play by Gonchar. Good no call.
Steve Downie on it for Philadelphia. Downie cradles it, then gave it up to the wrong guy. Malkin working in. Malkin to the front for Malone, and a good back check. Skyora feeds, backhand score! Ryan Malone!
Oh, if you're Steve Downie, John Stevens, so much faith in the rookie. Down in a heap is Skyora. Biron beaten. Steve Downie didn't get the puck out of his defensive zone. That led to the third goal, go-ahead goal in game two, and now a very ill-advised, get the puck deep. How long have we been saying it? Instead of putting the puck this way, let's roll it from here, guys. Our Burger King telestrator shows us what Steve Downie could have done, should have done. Nice little play here. He doesn't go this way with it. Instead, he wants to go this way. Well, fraught with all kinds of bad opportunities. And that just leads to Malkin getting it into the zone. And from there, good pressure, good numbers. And bad things happen when you have the outnumbered attack coming that way. You cannot turn the puck over at the offensive blue line. Steve Downie now knows this.
On target to Hossa. Empty net yawning. Bullseye! Marion Hossa finishes it for Pittsburgh.
John Stevens has seen his team pretty much blanketed by Hossa and the gang. And how about that? You're looking for similarities between Pittsburgh and Detroit. Your top line is out there protecting that lead. Certainly disappointment tonight for Flyers fans.
Resigned to the fact that Pittsburgh will take a 3-0 lead in this playoff series. And everybody who's a hockey fan knows their history lesson about how difficult that is to overcome. Pittsburgh giving Philadelphia the shivers. It's 3-0. The final count is 4-1. Just the fourth team in NHL history to win 11 of its first 12.
Crosby set a nice tone early. A real good jump to a step. He and Hossa in tandem.
The Pittsburgh Penguins, in much the same way that Detroit has done out west, taking a 3-0 series lead in their respective final. They've got this one under control. They'll go for the clincher here Thursday night, and we'll bring it your way. The opening faceoff a little after 7:30 Eastern time. Happiness for the guys in the white sweaters. Plenty of work to do, and that's an understatement for the gentlemen in black. For Darren Elliott, for Chris Simpson, for all the men and women in our crew, Joe Beninati thanking you for your time as we send you to Hockey Central, presented by Bud Light. Turning things over now at the studio to Bill Patrick.